Hello, everyone. We're watching Series of Unfortunate Events. So I'm gonna skip the intro because. Skip intro. Because it's really long. It's 1:17.
There's no word to describe the feeling of waking up and knowing instantly that something is terribly wrong. If there were, the Baudelaires would have used that word when they rose to find dawn. Their Uncle Monty had not.
Uncle Monty? Are you in here?
He's dead.
We all know that our time in this world is limited, and that eventually all of us will go to sleep, never to wake up. That didn't change how the Baudelaires felt that morning. The room their uncle had filled so carefully with specimens, and in which he was now a sort of specimen himself.
How could this happen? You know exactly how this happened?
My. What a terrible accident.
Whoever discovers this will be very upset. For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come.
You murdered him.
Klaus, I'm surprised. A smarty pants boy like you ought to be able to figure out that jolly old Uncle Monty died from a snake bite, not murder. Look at the teeth marks on his cheek. Look at his cold, waxy face. Look at his unblinking eyes.
Stop it. Stop talking like that.
You're right. There's no time for chit-chat. We have a ship to catch, and I'd like to board in time to have a bottle of wine before lunch. Peru. We're going to Peru.
We wouldn't go to the end of the driveway with you, much less international waters.
Well, then I guess I'll have to take my own luggage.
There's Sunny.
Sunny! Let her out this instant! She won't be able to breathe!
I'm so tired of having to explain everything to you. You're supposed to be so smart, yet you persistently seem to forget about this. I'll leave some breathing holes for her.
No, stop!
I'm kidding! That's not the suitcase she's in. I don't think.
Please don't hurt her.
Then get in the car. There's no one to blame but yourselves. If you hadn't stranded me at the movies, I wouldn't have had to kill Monty, and we'd all be on our way to Peru, where I would have had to kill Monty. God, I hate driving stick.
You're just gonna leave him there?
Trust me, he doesn't mind. Of course, after they discover he's dead, you'll be long gone, and I'll be taking advantage of Peru's extremely lax guardianship laws.
You can't do so the country.
And who's going to stop me?
It's extremely rare for an accident to be a fortunate event. Luckily for the Baudelaires.
Furnace of hell!
This is one of those times.
Driving well below the speed limit.
Oh,
Violet Baudelaire.
I'm so grateful you ran into us.
Well, I wouldn't say that. It was clearly the fault of the other driver.
Goddess, I've never.
I thought there were three of you. There's the baby. You're not Dr. Montgomery.
Oh, my spleen. I think you ruptured him. Hello. My name is Stefano. I'm Dr. Montgomery Montgomery's new assistant. I don't know how to say it.
Uncle Monty's dead.
That's how to say it.
He's dead? It's terrible. How did it happen?
He was bitten by a snake. I was on my way now to get the coroner. The children were too hysterical to be left here alone.
He wasn't taking us to a coroner. He was taking us to Peru.
What about? See, hysterical.
The children must be confused. Dr. Montgomery has taken them to Peru. Last night he called me to insist on me rearranging my morning itinerary to bring them these passports.
He'd want me to have them.
Can't you see, Mr. Poe? That's Count Olaf. He's in disguise and he's trying to take us away.
Who am I? What am I doing? Don't you miss the vivid imagination of childhood?
I never had one.
An imagination or a childhood?
Children, you must be very distraught about losing your uncle. Count Olaf is a terrible man who tried to steal their fortune.
Really?
Yes.
And do I look anything like this account of Olaf?
No, you don't. Count Olaf has one long eyebrow and he has a very short beard. You have a very long beard, and I hope you don't mind me saying so. No eyebrows at all.
He shaved his eyebrow and he let his beard grow. Can't you see? Anyone could see that. Sorry. Count Olaf has a tattoo on his left ankle. It looks like an eye.
I hate to trouble you, sir, but just to put the children's minds at ease, would you be so kind as to show us your ankle?
I'd be happy to.
My apologies, Mr. Stefano.
It's no problem. As long as the vehicle is operational, then we really must be going.
No!
No.
No?
No. None of us are going anywhere until the police have been called.
Come on, man. It's just a fender bender.
About Dr. Montgomery.
What a sensible idea.
It's quite urgent. First name Montgomery. Last name Montgomery. No, this isn't a prank call. Hello? Hello?
Don't care if you have an audition for Equus. Get over here now.
I don't understand how I got on this tattoo.
Good news. I managed to get them to the local sheriff's department. It seems there's an escaped cow from a local dairy farm giving them the runaround, but they assured me they'll send someone as soon as they're able. They must have made quick work of that cow. May I help you, ma'am? Sir.
I'm Nurse Lucafont.
Nurse Lucafont? From the local sheriff's department's medical examiner's office?
From the local... I hear there's been a terrible accident involving a snake.
That was fast. I only just now made the call.
I believe speed is of the essence in an emergency, sir.
So everyone, go watch the rest.
Don't you want to...